Hey, Lucy.
Hey, hi.
Hey, you having fun at the Super Bowl?
Yeah, we're just, hanging.
Hey, you got a charger. The wireless has been killing my battery. Can I borrow that for a minute?
I'll charge it for you right now.
Just for like 5-10 minutes.
Yeah, I'll charge.
I'll charge this.
Craig, don't use that outlet. The guy told us not to use this outlet.
I know the guy said don't use the outlet, but it's one outlet. It's Lucy Lou. What's going to go wrong, huh? This is the Superdome. This thing's going to blow the whole stadium for 20 minutes. The whole thing's going to be dark. The show will be off the air and NFL history may be changed. It's one outlet. What could possibly go wrong?
It's the Craig Ferguson Super Bowl Special, starring in alphabetical order, Drew Brees, Steve Carell, Julie Chen, Neil Patrick Harris, Nikki Reed, and Channing Tatum, featuring the San Francisco 49ers Gold Rush cheerleaders, Sergeant Danny Kramer and Officer George Jackson,
NOPD,
Secretariat, music by Bone Patrol. And yours truly, Jeff Peterson. We'll be back from New Orleans after these messages. Ladies and gentlemen, from New Orleans, Craig Ferguson.
That's fine. It's all right. I think America understands that you're all liquored up. Please, sit down. Relax. Before we continue, can I just say thank you to the 49ers cheerleaders, please? Can we thank them? I mean, let's be honest. Their team lost and they still came here. Actually, I think that was their punishment. They had to come here. It's a great day for America, everybody. Yes, indeed. Yeah. A great day if you're a Ravens fan. Your team just won the Super Bowl. The Lombardi Trophy is going back to Baltimore, but do not worry, Niners fans. In California, a Super Bowl loss counts as a prescription for medical marijuana. Refreshing down here. It's a fantastic city. There's so much that we don't have in LA. They have history and clean air and professional football. Carbohydrates. A lot of people, the people are just fantastic here. New Orleans was once a French colony and a very strong French influence here. It's kind of like being in France, except the people are friendly. And that's how, if you want to speak the accent, I'm right now. I mean, if you want to speak the accent, what you do is you pretend you're speaking French, like, hello, how are you? And then you just throw in a bit of honey boo-boo. So you, yes, that's right. Yeah, I'm going to tell America how you people sound. So what you do is you speak a little French, and then you add the honey boo-boo. You want to try it, Jeff?
Yeah.
All right, so you say, hello, how are you?
Hello, how are you?
Now add the honey boo-boo.
Bong, diddly, bong, ding,
there you are. That's how you do it. Anyway, it's fantastic being here in Jackson Square, named after Andrew Jackson, who defeated the British at the Battle of New Orleans. Had the British won... Yeah, well done. Yeah. All right, you weren't in the Super Bowl, but you beat the British a long time ago. Good. Now, had the British won, things would be very different. You'd be watching a talk show host that had an... I'm going down a bad street here with that. It would be... No, had the British won, it would be like Downton Abbey in New Orleans. Yes, it would. People would be talking like this all the time. Let the bon temps rule old. Right, Jeff?
I say, buku krasu.
You know what else they've got here? They've got... They're very famous for their food. They've got... I'm sorry, I have to go. That's the signal, Jeff.
It's time now, Craig.
Kill the Queen! Kill the Queen! Do you know that during Mardi Gras, they make a pastry called Louisiana King Cake, and it has a small trinket baked inside. You know it's a small trinket because I did a little leprechaun dance there. Whenever I do a leprechaun dance, that's how I am implying smallness. For example, if I was to go, hello, Tom Cruise, you would understand. Who am I saying hello to, Jeff?
Oh, Tom Cruise.
Tom Cruise. It's a small trinket baked inside it, and whoever finds the trinket is king for the night. Although the trinket itself has no actual importance, it's like a wedding ring on a Kardashian. Boom!
Yeah.
Oh, do you owe me? Do you owe me? Craig, I can't believe you did a Kardashian joke at the Super Bowl! I had to. Looks like there's a storm coming in. I think we're gonna have to take a commercial break in order to hold the old order to bing bong.
All right, I'll get you out of here, Craig.
All right, get me out of here.
All right, let's do it, fellas.
Get out of here.
Super Bowl Special, sponsored by TurboTax. You work hard to earn your money, and TurboTax puts the power in your hands to keep more of it. And by Red's Apple Ale. Branch out.
You having a problem there, buddy?
Yeah, man, I'm just trying to book a flight. It's taking forever.
I'm finding it very easy.
Well, how?
Well, I'm on kayak.com. You compare hundreds of different travel sites at once. You search one and you're done. Kayak.com. It's perfectly simple. I thought a robot, you would be friendly with the new technology, the computers and the websites and such.
Yeah, I am, but not in that way. Oh, it's beautiful.
Oh, my Lord. It's just that we're having such a wonderful time, but there's a storm coming in. You feel it? You know what that is?
Yeah, they're coming for your ass.
Coming for my ass. I noticed the band are beginning to sweat a little bit.
Yeah.
Hey, what time is it, Jeffrey Pearson?
It's time to take advice from a man who once danced under the name Fat Tuesday.
Hey!
It's Tweet Mail time.
Tweet Mail time!
Yeah.
Storm coming in. Can you feel the storm coming in?
Aye.
Arr. Why, it's blowing me papers around. And if you know there's one thing I enjoy, it's having me papers blown around.
Aye.
Hey, do you hear that?
That's the signal, Craig.
That's the signal. Let's go.
We're being called home now, Craig.
It's a giant choo-choo trumpet.
Is that a sex thing?
Yeah. A sex thing?
Yeah.
A giant... It's not stopping!
That means it's working.
Oh, I'm enjoying it. First it was the honk, then the rumble.
Didn't you once dance under... Oh, never.
Yeah, never mind. This is from Missy in Santa Fe, New Mexico. You ever been in New Mexico?
Beautiful place. Yeah, beautiful
fantastic.
Place.
You like know, if you want to get turquoise, that's the place.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, that's... There you are. And also, what else do they have in New Mexico, that lovely thing?
Dirt.
Crystal meth.
Crystal meth. Meth.
Yeah.
Crystal meth.
Crystal meth. What happens to you if you take crystal meth, though, Jeff?
Take a look at me.
Take a look at Jeff. Missy says, dear Craig and Jeff, what did the girls say when you went into the club on Bourbon Street last night? You know what they said! What did the girls say when we go to the club, Jeff?
Here come the players!
And then what do they say, Jeff?
They're so fine!
Dear Craig and Jeff, did any of your favourite friends like Michael Caine or Liam Neeson join you for a trip to the Super Bowl, or did you leave them at home? Michael Caine is here, and also...
Liam Neeson.
Thanks. This is from Danny in Trent, New Jersey. He says, hi there, Craig and Jeff. Do you have a lesbian row in New Orleans? Yeah. Right down front there, that rat row right there. Is it where you are? Lesbian row, right there. This is from Lee in New Orleans, Louisiana. She says, hey, Craig and Jeff, what's that big building over there? That's that one there. That's the Café du Monde. You go right over there. That is one of the largest cafes in Louisiana. It's not the biggest. There is a bigger one in Lafayetteville.
That's true.
Finally, this is from Carrie in Raleigh, North Carolina. Says, hi, Craig and Jeff. Two questions. Do you have a door? Yes. And then who's that at the door? I don't know. Who's that at the door? He's a seven-time Pro Bowler. He's a Super Bowl MVP winning quarterback of the New Orleans Saints. Please welcome Drew Brees, Yeah, no, he knows who that is. It's all right. Wow, is that crushed
that is
velvet?
Velvet, yes.
Whoa, man.
Yes.
You're making a little money, right? Yeah. Yes, you are.
It's just for you.
I notice you're not wearing your ring.
No, I'm thinking about the place where the next one's gonna go.
Ah, see. Yeah. You've gone totally native here, though. You're New Orleans now, because you're a Texan, aren't you?
Yes, but New Orleans kind of grabs hold of you and doesn't let go. So. Yeah.
Now, what's this thing you do with the 60 Minutes things with the kids? 60 Minutes it's, activity
well, yeah,
a day?
It's the 60 Million Minutes Challenge, but it's basically a Connect for Xbox 360 program, which basically encourages kids to get out and live a healthy and active lifestyle by exercising 60 minutes a day.
See, if I could keep my kids down to 60 minutes a day.
Right. Listen, I'm with you. I know you got two. I got three young boys at home.
So what age are your kids then?
4, 2, and 5 months.
You don't sleep at all, do you?
No, well, my wife doesn't sleep at all. I just get run ragged all day long with those three.
Yeah, no, it's three boys?
Three boys.
Yeah, I got two boys. It's nice to be out, isn't it?
Yeah. this is a rare occasion.
Yeah, it's nice. No, let's just hang here for a bit.
Yeah. just some peace and quiet.
Yeah.
Yes.
Here's the thing. I don't know if you know this. I'm not from around here. I grew up in a different country, and I don't know how to play football at all.
Yeah.
But you can throw a ball pretty good, right? Could you throw a ball close enough to me that you think I could probably catch it?
No doubt, absolutely. Now where from?
All right, well, let's say up from up the back there near that.
Right.
Like, see these drunk people in the back row?
Yeah.
I'm going to need this.
All right, you're going to need that.
All right, here we go. And here, I tell you what, you probably should wear this as well.
All right.
It's too small. It's crushing my head.
All right.
I want a mask like yours, Drew. All right, you ready?
All right,
drum roll. Put a drum roll.
Here we go. Drum.
There you go.
All right.
Craig Ferguson Super Bowl Special, sponsored by Kayak. Compare hundreds of travel sites at once. Kayak.com, search one and done. And by Microsoft. Meet the new Windows Phone, the smartphone reinvented around you.
With something dirty.
No. A beignet?
So when people say, show me your beignets?
No. Oh, that's something entirely different.
All right.
Do you know what's happening once we get in here?
Not really, no.
All right. This is...
Hello.
Hello. Yo, how you doing tonight?
Very well, thank you. This is my friend Steve.
Hi, how are you?
Hello, Steve, how are you today?
Good to meet you.
Great, what's nice happening, baby? Pleasure to meet you all.
We'd like you to open some oysters for us, please.
Okay, I'll tell you, the first one will be your last, and your last one will be your first, so you give one a try.
All right. All right.
Give that a try.
You go ahead.
Well, I'm actually allergic to oysters, but...
Oh, now you tell me.
Really? Mm-hmm. I've never had an oyster.
You never had an oyster?
Well, actually, no.
I've heard they're delicious. You should have
You... I don't know. I mean, no disrespect. I know that oysters are lovely and people adore them, but it looks to me like snot in a little cup.
You know what they say about them now, oysters, don't you?
What?
Mm-hmm. Eat fish, live long, eat oysters. Ooh, cha-cha-cha, baby. All four of these are good-looking oysters, but you see that one there?
Yes.
That one guarantees to please, not to tease, knock it down to your dog on knees, and you're going to get back up and do it again, even if you're too old for it.
Right, I don't know what you said, but I'm going to do it.
Can I show you? Yeah, you do drink it. Go ahead. Come on, we'll work with that together, if you don't mind.
You're here to mock me? You're really here to mock me?
This is what you do. So you won't get the shell in your mouth, you take it like that, you put your lips on top and kiss it like that. I need to make a little noise. Ooh, that was good. Good, very smart.
You
want
to,
Oh, why not?
He's
allergic. Oh,
oh
yeah.
My goodness.
He's like
Hollywood
allergic. I think you know what I'm saying.
I'm going to even wipe this off. Yeah. Right.
He's Hollywood allergic. I'm oyster intolerant, so...
You just like... And then just, do you chew it?
Chew it,
just...
Yeah, get a few bites so you can get that nice sweet brine from it.
Hmm? And that's the only way it's going to work.
Make the sound.
Can I make the sound and not eat the oyster? Because I can do that. Yeah. There I... Oh, that was delicious. All right, you ready?
Yeah.
Let's go for it.
Man.
Now, I did mine, and I don't even eat oysters now. Isn't that something? And I'm allergic.
You allergic?
See, I only say
now
that
you're
one.
Mocking.
Yeah, we are. All right, here we go, right? Just, like, go like that, and...
And just rock with it, baby.
Okay.
up top, but you didn't chew it. Now it's gonna wiggle and jiggle. Oh my goodness, what did you just do? For you, my good friend.
You look like an old pro at that.
You look like an old pro. That's it.
How was it?
You know? It was kind of the way I thought it was gonna be. And now that I've done it, I feel okay.
Well, that's great.
I don't need another one, though.
You don't need another
one? That was a really very rich one.
Okay, it can be.
Yeah.
It can last you for a couple of days.
Yeah, I think that'll last me for a little longer.
Even if you don't
You probably should have one, though, I think.
No, I'm allergic.
I've noticed you're actually getting a little sweaty.
Yes, I'm noticing myself.
I am.
You're kind of freaking out a little bit. All right, let's go sit down and have a salad or something. Come on, it's all right. Come on.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you very much, though. Those are lovely. That's the best snot I ever had.
Oh, my God.
I am totally. Oh, my God.
I can't believe I ate it. I can't believe you made me eat that oyster, and you were sweating next to the oysters.
I'm sweating just thinking about
it. Yeah, you were cruel. You made me eat an oyster, and now you have to do something for me.
All right.
You have to eat this pepper.
Oh, no.
Yeah. No, this one.
That
one? No, I touched that one. You got to eat it.
Just, like, take a bite in the middle?
What do you mean, a bite in the middle? Like, yeah, and then eat it and chew it.
Oh.
Ow. Is it very hot here? Quick.
That's got some.
Have some cheese.
Parmesan's not gonna help. Wow.
Ah, that'll teach
you. Oh, my glass is steaming up.
Here, have some water. No, water's wrong. Milk. We need milk. Butter's the only thing we have.
That was. I thought that'd be very mild. Oh my gosh. No, it's fine.
All cut together nicely.
Oh. Wow. See, the thing about that is that it. I really didn't expect that.
I didn't think it would be that hot either. I thought it was just like a thing we were doing.
I was a little garnish on the salad.
You look really like, I feel terrible and happy at the same time.
My nose is dripping.
Whenever I go into a strange new town, the first thing I want to do is visit an interesting old cemetery. Do I?
Yes.
I did it again this time with one of the stars of the Twilight movies, Nikki Reed. Take a look at this.
This is what I like to do, is go to towns that I don't know that well or haven't been in for a while and take a very attractive girl for a walk in the graveyard. I did it with Mila Kunis in Glasgow. She had a great time.
Yeah, that totally sounds like...
She's traumatized. She hasn't spoken to me since. But I think you'll like this. What we do is we'll walk in the graveyard and you'll see it's very historic.
I wanted to come do this with you.
Before we go into the graveyard, here's the rules. I don't walk over anybody's graves, which will be okay in here because they're all above ground.
Right, so.
And no cussing.
Oh, okay.
I just made that one up.
I don't, have we cursed a lot?
No, we haven't
Today,
cursed
so
at
then,
all.
Yeah, where are we? Does balls count? Things like that?
Well, you see, that you just said balls right come out. I thought that was a rat, but it's a squirrel. That would have been more kind of exciting if it was a rat. Would you come here at night on your own?
I don't know what I would do here at night on my own.
Ask you what you do. Like.
So I just, there's no real reason. Do you come here at night on your own?
Yes, I do, but I,
well,
I sleep
what do you do?
Here.
Have you slept here? But have you slept at a cemetery?
In a cemetery?
Yeah.
Not on purpose, but back when I was drinking, I inadvertently took a nap in a cemetery one evening.
And is that why
you like blackout
to revisit?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I think it would be kind of cool actually to come here at night, but I don't know. I would have to think of, well, this one's a little creepy.
This is a very atmospheric.
And I like that they've placed the bench right here, like in case you just wanted to sit and read a book or.
Well, no, it's for people to come and remember their loved ones. That's what it is.
Oh.
You know, they come here and they sit and they're...
I'm the worst.
Well, look. In memory of Captain C.H. Kemp, who died at sea.
I guess, what is his family there?
Nah, it's just, it's kind of like a condo for dead people, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. Look at that!
What?
It's a blimp. It's a blimp. Look, look, a blimp.
You know, people have, like, there's people who are afraid of blimps. I mean, there's people who are afraid of everything, but there's like a blimp phobia.
Well, yeah, if you grew up in London in the the early part of the First World War, and you were getting bombs dropped on you from Zeppelins, then I think it would be fair to be afraid of them. Other than that, I don't understand why you would be.
Wait, let me ask you something seriously.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so the squares, is it because people are laid flat and shoved in like that?
Yeah.
It's like a tray?
Yeah, like drawers.
Like drawers?
Yeah.
I was thinking baking again, so I was going with that.
It's kind of like that's kind of it's like a pizza oven, but
full of. That's not disrespectful, is it?
No, I don't think so.
Okay, good.
I think that
so we have to
everyone
stay really
everyone loves pizza. Who doesn't like pizza?
Totally.
How are you going to be interred when your time's up?
I will probably be cremated.
Really?
Well, yeah, now it's documented, so if I don't, I'll look like a dead liar.
Well, but no one will take it. But I thought you're Jewish. Is cremation okay in the Jewish faith?
I don't know the answer to that, but that's what I would do. I just feel like, I don't know, I feel like it's the right, for me, it would be the right thing to do.
You know what, ask me what I'm going to have done.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Sorry about that. This is a conversation.
Chronology being what it is, chances are I'll pop off before you.
What are you going to do?
I think I'd like to be placed out in an open wooden boat and then put out to sea and pecked at by seabirds.
How dramatic of you.
Hold on, I'm not finished. before being lit on fire.
Wow, you just really want to, even when you're dead, you need to be the center of attention.
You know,
huh?
The truth is you can throw me in the trash. It's fine. I don't care.
These are really, I've never seen anything like this.
They're very beautiful, aren't they?
Yeah, very beautiful.
And you know why they had to build them above ground like this?
Probably something to do with the sea?
Yes, because the water table here, if you buried the corpses, they would float up. And then when they did that, vampire legends and zombie legends are born. And some of us make our living out of these things, don't we?
Stop. Wait, stop it.
Yes, that's true.
Is that true?
Look, there's a cat, black and white cat. You know what that means?
That means that we're...
Good luck for me, bad luck for you. Or
why?
Other way around.
Yeah, definitely the other way around.
But it's nice. There you got it. That's good. Pretty much everything you can imagine happens in Bourbon Street. I was there earlier this week with a guy who owns one of the best restaurants in the French Quarter. Take a look at this.
You were a football player, weren't you?
Yes, sir.
You any good?
All right. That was okay. Yeah. I like to bang a little bit.
I know that. Clearly, that's why you have the bar. But were you any good at football?
I was all right. Yeah, no, I love the sport. I played 1 year in college and then I just wrapped it up.
You got a baby coming.
Yeah, I'll never be there once the baby comes.
When is that?
Soon, like about the next few months. Next few months, man. Yeah. I'm terrified but excited.
It's your first, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, you'll be all right. It's not that okay. It's gonna be bad.
Yeah, it's gonna be terrible.
Yeah, you don't sleep.
At all?
I got two. You don't sleep. You don't ever sleep again. Apparently, I thought when they get older, you would sleep, but they don't. You just worry about different stuff. So you're just like worried all the time. Like,
when's the gear shift? When are you out of the woods as far as like?
You're not out of the woods.
Ever?
I can see. No, I mean like
this
my parents.
This feels like a good idea then.
Yeah, no, it's you're screwed. You buy the bar and then live in the bar. It'll be fine. This is a nice place. This is your place.
Yeah, man. This is it. This is we had this horrible idea about a year and a half ago. And
that's
then,
a terrible business idea to open a drinking establishment in Bourbon Street. You're going to lose all your money.
Well, we're going to drink it all away more than likely. If we don't, if the employees don't drink it all, then someone else hopefully will.
So all your friends working here?
Yeah, pretty much, which is also a terrible idea.
That's going to work out great. You're going to, it's going to be fine.
they don't like drinking. No,
they just want to work in the bar for the, it's like to see the life around.
They just want to, you know, help out the establishment.
You're going to make so much money with this.
I hope so. I mean, it's one of those things we decided to do. I'm from about 45 minutes east of here in Mississippi, in Pascagoula Gochet, and we'd always come here. And this was like larger than life, this place. Like, you know, to see girls being crazy and getting naked and like everybody
fighting.
Is that
still
happening? Yeah, well, open the windows and I'm sure you'll have to blur it out.
People look particularly small to me, like regular-sized people. Why is it called little people's? Why is it called little people's?
I'm going to show you. Little people, my sister-in-law, my wife over there.
Why is it called little people's?
She is little.
Can she step out? It's very little.
She's 5 feet, and all my siblings are.
Oh, well, that's nice.
But the customers don't have to be little.
No,
yeah,
right. No.
It used to be back in the days when there was segregation, you would only serve little people. Is that right?
No.
All right.
Nice try.
No, I didn't think so. What are we going to eat?
Oh, we're going to eat some nice Rodney turkey necks.
Rodney turkey necks.
Okay.
All right. Nice.
Now,
oh, boy, look at that.
Necks, potatoes.
What was that broth? Yeah.
The broth is a special delivery like for Rodney.
We have a fork? You guys wait there. I'll go get a fork. Oh, there you
right.
go.
Thank tongs, you very much even indeed. Better.
There you go. Look right. at that. Tongs.
Now, it's spicy, right?
Yes.
Is it spicy?
Okay, very good.
This is good and spicy.
There you go. That's
thank right. you.
The corn.
All right.
Turkey necks.
Turkey, this is that.
That's smoked sausage.
That's smoked sausage, right.
Right.
Okay.
That's turkey neck right there.
Turkey neck. There's your turkey
ooh,
neck.
Thank right. you.
There you go. What, you want some sausage?
Right.
Corn. You want some corn?
Yeah.
Oh, there you go.
All
right.
Good, good.
All right.
Good.
All right.
Thank you.
And I'm going to have a turkey. Do you want ones anyway? You want a
ooh,
turkey
this
neck?
This looks delicious.
Yeah. All right. That looks like a turkey neck. I think that turkey was double jointed. Maybe. Oh, no, it's two turkeys.
Now, Craig was saying that during Mardi Gras, the parade goers contribute to the ingredients and throw things in the pot.
Oh,
is that
yeah.
true? He made that up.
That's true.
Get out of here.
Man, that's true. Great.
Good, huh?
That is great.
That's why they call it Rodney Turkey neck.
Wow, that is great.
Just can't eat one.
I didn't have a fork, but you'll notice that I didn't care or even wait to get one.
This is worth not using a fork.
Wow.
Right.
That is
very
delicious.
Good.
How hard is it to buy turkey neck?
Oh, it's not hard at all.
It comes with the rest of the turkey. You just buy a whole turkey and the next there.
It's usually headless, isn't it?
Yeah, right.
Oh, that's right. So do you buy the head, turkey heads?
Just neck.
You can buy just necks?
Just, yes.
Where? In L.A.?
Yeah, no, not in L.A. I don't know
about L.A., but I know about around the corner.
That's the easiest one. Okay, we got to get out of here.
This
you guys make the best turkey neck I ever tasted.
Thank
you make the only turkey neck I ever tasted, but it's fantastic.
I don't even want the sausage. I don't even want the sausage.
You don't want it?
No.
What, why are you even saying that? I'm still me. When you say lines like, I don't even want the sausage.
Uh-oh.
It's still me.
Don't take it personally.
Uh-oh.
Michael Caine in space on Bourbon Street.
Look at all them people. All you people are sober. I find that very disappointing. Yes, you're all very sober and respectable. I want to see unrespectable people taking their breasts out. There you go, there's one.
What are you talking
about? No. Like all the girls walking up and down, I want to throw them beads, but every time I throw them beads, they just walk away. But the ugly fat blokes, they're like, oh, hey, Michael.
Why are you laughing? Nah, don't. My next guest is an Emmy Award-winning actor. He stars in How I Met Your Mother Monday nights at 8 o'clock on CBS. Please welcome Neil Patrick Harris, everybody.
you have been on the show so often with me, they gave me a card with your details on it. Look what they wrote on it. Look at that. Neil Patrick Harris, nothing. How are you, pal? You look great. I like your jacket.
Thank you very much. I like you catching footballs.
Ah, come on.
Ah!
Look how windy it is, man.
Come on, you back. That first catch was hilarious.
No, God, it hit me.
You were
in the
like,
chest.
Oh! I've never felt more masculine than watching
come on,
you catch
knock it
a football.
Off, man. I was doing my best. I didn't go. Do you play football?
Well, better than that.
Ah, come on. Hey, have you been in New Orleans before?
No, this is my first time
That's
here.
Nice, isn't it? Isn't it
yeah. Oh. David and I are big foodies. We love eating great meals. And I mean, everywhere you go here, whether it's the fancy places, the big formal places, or just like a great po' boy and some beer, like everything here is great.
You had the frog's legs. They eat frog's legs here.
Where's this?
It's at the end of the frog. The frog's up this end, and then the legs are down here.
Oh, the leg part.
But here's the thing. When you eat the frog's legs,
yes.
It's not just like a separate leg and then another leg. It's like pants, right? So I won't touch them because you can't tell because they're wearing like little fried batter trousers.
Uh-huh.
They're wearing fried batter trousers, but I'm thinking, I think the junk's in here too.
You don't like fried frog junk?
I don't know because I'm too afraid to try it.
Let me tell you, Craig, it's delicious.
Really? Oh no. Like, I saw you in the hotel today, right?
Yes, sir.
And you were in the gym for like...
We got a little sweaty together.
Well, we did. And then we went to the gym.
Hey!
There you go. In fact, I think a freeze frame high five. Do it again.
Okay. All right.
Hey! All right, okay. So...
Yeah.
Hey, I think there's a storm coming.
There's a storm a-brewing.
Storm coming in.
What's happening, Craig?
Don't worry. You stick with me and you can have all the fried frogs junk you can eat. We're out of time.
We are?
I know, it's very fast down here.
Damn you, Drew Brees.
Yeah. I wouldn't say that here. I wouldn't say that around here. It's... That's not the thing to say.
What's this about this? That's cool.
Yeah.
It's like Indiana Jones with the thing on the side.
No, he's like, you know when people do Chuck Norris jokes?
Yeah.
It's because they're too afraid to do Drew Brees jokes.
I'm just kidding.
You know what I'm saying?
MVP, dude.
Yeah, yeah. All right. Well, we got to go. You want to
do your thing?
Well, yeah, do your thing. Yeah.
Well, it's been a lot of fun, everybody. We'll see you next time.
No. Well, what? I'm coming back. You're not.
Oh, just I'm leaving?
Yeah. I got other stuff to do. Oh, you want to stay the whole time?
Enjoy the boring 30 minutes.
Oh, hey! Neil Patrick Harris, everybody. We'll be right back. We've had a fantastic time here in New Orleans. We hope you enjoyed the show. I'd like to thank everybody who helped us out, including the New Orleans Police Department, who have got a much better relationship with me than most other police departments I know. Thanks a lot, everybody. Thanks to the people in New Orleans. Get out of here. Come on, let's go.